admitted me under 5 in table tennis. And that is, so, I mean, I was just joking. And then I played with him last visit, and I couldn't even score 5 points. And such a energetic person, you must have all seen him in action here. Actually, he is my role model. So positive and so energetic. So I'm just joking that I don't like him. Okay, now today, you can hear me? The last week. Okay. Today, what I wanted to discuss was some of the common orthopedic problems. I won't call diseases or ailments. All of us have to go through this. All of us, there is no way that you can counteract nature. So, how is the best way to face it? That is the thing I am going to talk to you in the next 45 minutes or whatever. And I want it to be as interactive as possible. Any time, any point of time, you can stop me and question me also. Okay, so general, I am going to talk to you. And this is, I am going to cover most of the common things, I am sure. Part of you will be having backaches, joint pains. Sometimes in your life would have had a fall, fractures, a visit to the hospitals. Might not be very pleasant visit, but we'll have to. There's no other alternative. We'll have to visit. And generalized fatigue and lack of interest in doing the routine things. Lot of things, I mean, most common things. I might have left out a few things you can come out with. This, I'll be talking to you not only from my professional experience, but with my personal experience also, because as Kanthan sir said, I am having 4 senior citizens, 80 plus in my house, both parents and in-laws. And so the practical aspects also I know, from that part, that their point of view and from our point of view, I am facing both the things, and I will be sharing my experiences with you. So what are the issues like? So the issues are, whatever may be the problems you might be facing, first thing is the heart wants to do something, right? You might want to go to Badri Yatra, right? Or somebody else might want to go to a temple in Tamil Nadu, okay? Or somebody else might want to go on a trek to Himalayas. They have lot of things in their mind, lot of things, but the body is not cooperating because of various reasons. Maybe the steps are too big to climb. You first think of it, whenever the moment you get up in the morning, you want to go to a marriage, you want to go to the native place, the first thing is you see if there is a commode there or not, right? Whether it is suitable for me, whether there is an Indian type of commode or there. Whether there are steps to climb up, whether you have to sit on the ground to have your lunch or to the puja. So lot of things will come. The body doesn't cooperate in what you want to do. Okay, the heart wants to do, the mind wants to do. But the thing is, this is the most important issue. The mind doesn't accept the fact that the body is not ready to do it. Body is not fit enough to, the Kanthan sir wants to play table tennis. Even now. But there are some limitations now after the age of 81. Still he beats me, that's a different thing. But he does it well. So there are some, every decade there are some limitations which the mind has to accept. We cannot do. That's it's easy for me to tell, but that has to be the way of life. That's what I felt. So the philosophy is inevitable. There is no way you can escape the pain, the physical pain. I'm not talking about the mental pain and other, a lot of other things, the backaches, the joint pains. Well, whether you really want to suffer, that is optional. Okay, how it is optional, I'm going to talk about.
Hello, sir.
Yes. Is it that bad? Do I really need a mic?
Yes.
Okay.
So,
okay, I got it. So, I would not like to go into directly the orthopedic treatment part. I would say that prevention is better than cure. So how do you exactly do it now? For no one would at any point of life. How do you exactly, what there can be a holistic approach to the whole problem, whatever is the problem. You can change your lifestyle, you can have a regular walks in the morning, really helpful, whatever, even if it is 80, 90 also. So, walking is the simplest exercise you do. Regular, time to time, balanced diet, what to eat, what not to eat, yeah, and what are the type of exercises you people can do. And important is the medicine. Medicines, there is a, every few months you have to do review, what all you are taking with the doctors that you are consulting, and you can change the timings, and of course, exercises and physiotherapy as and when necessary. So, the whole thing has to have a holistic approach. It's all preventive, basically. It's all the do's. It's a few examples. I won't be able to tell you the whole this thing. Like, if you have a choice of using a dining chair, please use a dining chair. Don't try to sit on the ground forcefully. Okay, at some point of time, say, I don't know, it can be as early as 60, as late as 80, you might have a problem. It's not sitting down is not a problem. Getting up will be a problem on the ground. Then, because that hold support, you need somebody to lift you up. So, if it is really painful, don't do it. You don't have to force, you don't have to prove to anybody that you are still sitting on the ground. Because every time there is pain, pain is the warning sign. Pain means that something is not accepting. The body is not accepting. So better not to insult the body. So avoid those activity which causes pain. That will be the main the way you have to go forward. Suppose bending forward, cleaning the back of the corner of the room, under the table is painful. Try alternate method. Have a plan B. You don't have to force yourself. You don't think that by forcing yourself to do that activity, the pain will vanish. It will not vanish. Okay? So that's what I'm saying. Please, these are the common things. Try to use the dining chair if you're sitting on the ground. If you have the option in the marriage hall to sit on the ground and the chair, please use the chair. Don't take it as an insult. And Western commode is better than sitting in the Indian type for the same reason. Even for having a bath, you can have a stool or a chair and then use this. If wherever, if necessary, if there is imbalance, if there is vertigo or if you feel that the road is not good, don't hesitate to use a walking aid. Please do it because the consequences are very, very disastrous. Because if you don't, if you are, say, I have got patients who feel insulted to use a walking stick. We are not that old. It's not the age or anything. One wrong step and the consequences are not good at all. I'll tell you what happens. And regular medical checkups is a must. You don't have a heart. Because anything can happen anytime. So regular medical, I would say after the age of 50, till 60, we tell once a year. Probably after 70, maybe once in 6 months also is a good time limit for the medical checkups. See your doctors. Sir, you wanted to have a question?
You said that use stool if you change it to a chair with arm.
Correct. I know, stools also can be, the type of quality of stools you get in the market, when you sit on it, the whole thing collapses. It has happened to me also. Yeah. Don't sit cross-legged. I mean, if it is possible without plain, please go ahead. I'm not telling those active people who are doing regular yoga and all, not an issue at all. If you are able to sit, there is no pain, the body is not grumbling, you can go ahead. And regular walking and a good diet will see that you don't put on weight. Weight is a great problem both for you and for us also as a treating physicians. Those who are obese come 100 plus, we have a lot of problems in treating those people. So we don't like people who are 100 plus. Weight wise, I'm telling you. not eat rice. Okay? And never stop walking. Whatever this thing, whenever you are able to walk, please go ahead. Walking will not increase the arthritis part of the joint. Some people have this wrong notion that the more you walk, the more weight on the knee joints and more arthritis. That is the wrong concept. These joints are like machines. It's a machine basically. As long as you use it, they are good. If you don't use it, it gets rusted. Okay, as long as you use it. It's like a fan. If you don't use a fan, after some time it starts making sound. So keep using every day, as much as possible. Knee joint has to go through that range of movement. Exercise, walking is a very good. So it keeps all the joints active. Okay, now this is about general preventive measures. I was telling you about walking stick. Why I don't want you to give up the walking aid, I would call it. I mean, those who are having problem, having instability, having vertigo, having the roads are not good. Because I get, almost every day I get one patient with a fracture. How many of you had a fracture here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's a good big number. Either it's the hip, or it's the wrist, or it's the spine. These are the three most common. And once a fracture, you'll need at least 1 month rest. 1 month is gone. You need somebody else to take care of you. Hip fractures are very dangerous. You'll have to need surgeries. The ball has to be changed, or we'll have to put this. Rods, plates, screws, it becomes a big hazard. I don't want any of you to have a fall here. That's the most important thing, the message I would like you to take back to your home, that how to avoid a fall. Because it can happen anytime. On the way back, by climbing stairs, in the house, in the bathrooms. So we just spend a little time. This is the all over the world statistics. So you see, every year you have around 6 lakh fractures. Every year. So that is the high volume. Even in India, it's quite a high volume. And the most unfortunate is the
statistics of India or the whole world?
This is the whole world. Indian data, we don't have much. So, but it's equally very high in India also. But the worst part is, it's very disastrous. 40% of them never think for 1 year. At the end of 1 year, only 60% are allowed to tell you the story. So, at any cost, please try to avoid the fall. And how, apart from falling down, apart from in younger age group, it is the road traffic accidents and other things. Here, you don't need such a big injury. So even while getting down the stairs or in the bathroom, if you fall, you might have a fracture. And some people I got a few patients, they were sitting in a chair, they got up and tuck, there was a fracture. It can be as delicate as that. The bones become very soft inside, especially after aging. So even if you suddenly sit somewhere, you might have a fracture. If you get up, also they are so brittle. They fall down and they say you don't have to fall because of the fracture. The first there is a fracture and then you fall. That also can happen. So it's so brittle. It's like glass. The glass is stronger in fact. More brittle than glass. Second reason is this is that osteoporosis. Osteoporosis is the brittle bones. After the age of 50, for ladies, 45 to 50, the calcium comes down. After the period stop, the calcium goes down. So it is a must. Calcium is a must. For gentlemen, it's 65. Ladies, it is 45 to 50, you have to start calcium every day. Because calcium is very, very vital for the functioning of the heart and brain. Blood has to have 10 milligram of calcium at any given point of time as long as the body is alive. So where does the heart and brain get the calcium. If you don't eat, take calcium in the diet or additional calcium, if you don't take the calcium in the diet, it has to survive. The heart has to beat. So it takes it from the bone storage. The bone has got a lot of storage from birth to teenage to 50 years. We have stored the calcium in the bones. So after 50, if you don't take supplements, the blood absorbs it from the bones to keep the 10 milligram level. I'll take the question. So the 10 milligram has to be there, 9 to 11 milligram average range, 10 milligram in the blood has to be there for the heart and the brain to work. So if we don't take supplemental calcium, it takes from the bones. So the bones become weak naturally for a period of time. 10 years we are not taking calcium and the blood is drawing all the calcium from the bones. So as it takes calcium from the bones become brittle. So any small injury, it breaks. So calcium is very, very important. Yes, ma'am.
The cardiologist says too much calcium calcifies the arteries and that's why you have blocks. So he said don't take calcium daily, especially women. Now, where do we stand against
this? Yeah, cardiologist is also right, but it doesn't happen to everybody. There is a small percentage of people whom we avoid calcium. Those who have a tendency to form the calcium plagues in the blood vessels. It doesn't happen to everybody. That what you take, the calcium doesn't go into the heart, directly into the plagues. Atherosclerotic plagues. More of the fat and the lipids that is there that blocks the blood vessels, not the calcium. But there are 1% of the people with parathyroid problems. They have this tendency to misutilize the calcium. Two things can happen. As you said, cardiologists, I give a lot of respect. Those who have this doubt in their brain, I ask them to consult, go back to the cardiologist. Second thing is, some people form kidney stones. Calcium stones in the kidneys. They have to take, but they have to give a break in between. Okay? And stop for some time and again take calcium.